In this episode, I'm going to show you how to get this old school film look in After Effects. There are a ton of tips, tricks, and shortcuts along the way, so you definitely don't want to miss this tutorial. Check out the description for links to my brand new School of AE, offering courses, personalized coaching, animation presets, MoGraph project files, and templates. Also check out the links for ways to support this channel. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so I have this footage of a record player, and I want to add some effects to give it an old school film look. So first, let's Command Option Y to create a new adjustment layer, and I'm just going to name this Film Look. Okay, so now we need to add quite a few effects, so just add these along with me, and then we'll take a look at them one at a time. So first, let's look for Add Grain, then we'll just double click that. Next up is Fractal Noise. Then we're going to add in a Tritone. Now let's add in an offset. Okay, up next is fast box blur, so just type in fast box. We'll double click to add that. And then let's type in transform. Next I'm going to type in vignette, and we're going to add a CC vignette. And finally, type in force motion for force motion blur. Okay, so I'm going to go over to my effects controls panel and Command A to select all of these effects. And I'm just going to close them up and turn them all off except for the first one. And we'll go down one at a time and make some adjustments. Change our viewing mode from preview to final output. I'm going to change my intensity to 1.5. Open up color here and check monochromatic. So now I'm going to push in here and then toggle this layer off and on. And you can see the difference that this add grain makes. Shift forward slash will fit our viewer back into our window. Close up add grain and go down to fractal noise. Change our brightness down to negative 80. Let's open up our transform settings and we're going to uncheck uniform scale. Let's make our width 5 and our height 4000. Okay, now let's change our complexity down to 1. And then let's go down to our evolution here and we're going to option or alt click on the stopwatch for evolution and type in time times 1000. Okay, then let's change our blending mode from normal to screen. Okay, so let's close up fractal noise and go down to tritone. And the only change we need to make is to this blend with original. Let's just change this to 50%. You can close that up and then open up offset. Go to about the 2 second mark and we're gonna put a keyframe for shift to center. Press U to reveal our keyframe. Go forward a little bit on the Y axis. We want this to flip one time. So we're gonna subtract 540 minus 1080. Watch this play back. You can see how we're going to get that little flip right there. Adjust your keyframes to get the speed that you're going for. Okay, let's move forward about 4.5 seconds. We're going to put another keyframe there. Go down a little bit. And let's take this negative 540 and subtract 2160. That's going to flip 2 full times. And again, just move your keyframe to get the speed that you're going for. We're going to do this one more time, just put a keyframe at about 8 seconds, move forward a bit, and this time I'm going to add 1080. So this will go in the opposite direction. So instead of flipping up, it'll flip down. Okay, so let's close up offset, and then let's turn on our fast box blur. So around 1 second, let's add a keyframe for blur radius set at 0. And then let's close up this layer and then press U to reveal our keyframes. So that way we see our keyframes for both offset and fast box blur. I'm going to go forward just a few frames, and I'm going to increase my blur radius to 20 to really blur this out. I'm going to move a little bit further and then change our blur radius back to 0. So the result will be just a really quick blur. Copy those keyframes and then paste in between these two offset animations. I'm going to kind of spread this out to get a little bit of a different look. Paste those keyframes again. I'm going to make this one kind of quick. And then one more time at the very end, just paste. And then let's just kind of spread these out to get a slightly different look. Move these keyframes around, let's select all of those keyframes and F9 to make those easy ease. Okay, so we're done with fast box blur. Let's open up transform. We're going to put an expression on our position control. Just type wiggle 5, 10. And that's going to give our screen just a little bounce. And if we look at the bottom of our screen, we can see that we're going to have some transparency kind of creeping through here. So let's just increase our scale up to 105. Okay, let's close up transform, open up CC vignette. And I'm just going to change my amount to 250 and my angle of view to 50. Scrub through this offset animation. You can see that there's no motion blur here. And you won't have motion blur even if you add it at the layer level because the footage isn't actually moving. We kind of have this illusion of it moving with this offset effect. So let's add a force motion blur, and now we have motion blur. Force motion blur is going to really bog down your system. It eats up a lot of RAM, so you may want to take it off until you're ready to render. Okay, so let's say this as an animation preset. Open up our effects and make sure that you select every one of these effects. Go up to animation, save animation preset. You want these to go into your documents, Adobe, the version you're using. I'm in 2023, user presets, and I have a folder for 7-Minute AE. You can either drop your preset right in your user presets folder, or you can make a folder structure the way I have. I'm just going to call this film underscore look. And let's click save. And I always want to make sure that my animation presets save properly. So let's just get rid of this layer here. Let's go over to our effects and presets. And I'm going to type in film underscore look. And there's our preset right there. So just make sure you don't have any layers selected. And we have keyframes with this animation preset. So wherever your playhead is, that's where it's going to drop your first keyframe. And then just double click. You notice that it comes in on a solid. Whenever you save animation presets on an adjustment layer, whenever you call it back in, it will add it to a solid. But you can make any solid an adjustment layer by just clicking this button right here. Okay, if we press U to reveal our keyframes, we can see all of our keyframes came back in. And that's how you can get a film look on just one layer.